there she is, Joana Carvalho, Pro-Rector, University of Porto, responsible for sports and quality of life at the university. And as I said before, she's a professor in the sports faculty. Hi, how are you?
Thanks for the invitation of being here with you.
No, it's really nice of you to join us. It's we had a nice chat yesterday. In fact, Joana and I, you know, just talking about what we're going to be discussing today. Mm-hmm. And I can tell you she's a really fun person. So I'm looking forward to this a lot. So, you know, Joana, I hope you had a nice Easter weekend. I hope everyone who's joining us also did. Yeah?
A little bit more than used to, but we should do in this weekend days.
Exactly. I mean, you know, we have to make the most of the little things that we have now. So, you know, let me start by asking you, you're somebody whose your life is all about physical activity and about sport and about moving and being active. How are you personally coping with this COVID-19 situation, which has really restricted all of us so much?
Yeah, in fact, it's an unusual time. The entire world is fighting with this rapid spread of coronavirus, confining all of us at our homes and radically altering the way we move and the way we work. But thanks to this digital technology, we can communicate, and that's why I'm still working at home.
But do you find the lack of physical activity restrictive, or are you managing to do stuff at home?
I think despite this crisis that affects everyone everywhere, we should have a positive point of view and try to stay active and healthier, even at home. I think it's time for us to realize how important physical activity is and how important communication and education is. So we must be now a little bit of inventive in this kind of
way. Yeah, exactly. I think, you know, so I'm coming to that. I think it's interesting for us to understand, how are you actually communicating with your student community? Because there's a lot of information out there on online, on the web, talking about staying fit and staying active and what you can do at home. And every second day, people are posting fitness videos, and I'm almost sick of them. But how are your students reacting, and what kind of communication have you had with your student community to make sure that they are keeping their motivation up?
Yeah, you know, as you said, I'm a sport person, so I try to maintain a balanced lifestyle in this confined situation, and to safeguard my mental and health and physical health. That's very, very, very important. Otherwise, I will become a very sedentary person. Yeah. And that's why we are still going on, trying to motivate our students also to, and not only our students, our community, globally, because we are trying to spread a lot of classes.
Okay.
4 classes a day.
So when you say classes, you're talking about some kind of physical activity classes that you're doing online?
Yeah.
That's good.
In fact, we closed our sports facilities since 12, I think.
Yeah.
And the day after, since 13 or 14, we start to have free online classes in different social networks, Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. And we try to do exercises for all ages, from kids activities, you know, persons are at home with their kids.
Ask me. I don't know what to do with all their energy.
And also for older people. So we try to have a spread of activities for different ages and also for different interests. You know, we have yoga, we have, for instance, strength training, we have circuit training, we have dancing. So
has the response has been good with like a lot of people joining and stuff online?
Yeah, we have a wonderful, I think it's a success, because I can say to you that now we have almost half million of views. That's very nice.
That's actually really good. Yeah.
We have a lot of new followers. So okay.
It's working. That's nice.
Even at home, I think we are creating opportunities for people to get involved in physical activity.
So, you know, this is really the crucial thing. How do you get people involved? I know so many people who don't really consider themselves sporty. And they are the ones who feel sometimes confused in times like this, you know, where everybody's talking about home workouts and things. But there are people who don't really think of themselves as sporty. So what can you suggest to them to do in these times? Because, you know, for them, you can't tell them go and bench press the kitchen table. You can't tell them to start. They're not going to do that. I'm one of those people. I'm not going to do that. So what do we do?
I'm not a sporty people.
I am. But, you know, like I said, there's people who are zero, then there's people in the middle, and then there's super sporty people. I'm sort of somewhere in the middle. Don't tell me to do something too complicated, basically.
Yeah, we really want people to keep active while staying active, even those that normally do not exercise. So for that kind of people, I can say that they can take, of course, our online classes, of course, very carefully, because they are starting to go on, and that's why our fitness instructors have different kinds of tips when they are doing their exam. They, for instance, say different complexity and different intensities. If you are stronger, you can still go on. Otherwise, be careful with this and that. That's very important, because if you never exercise and now with time, you should do it, but with carefully.
With care, yeah. Yeah. So tell me, Joana, you talked about the dance classes. That sounds like a lot of fun. Now, you know, so I just saw one of the questions coming up from someone who's joined. Like, if they want to join one of these classes, where do they have to go? Do they just go to the University of Porto website?
Yeah. It says UPorto.
Okay.
Sport.
Okay.
They are on the Facebook, in the Instagram, and also in YouTube. And you know, we have a schedule. Every day we have 4 minutes, but if you can get it afterwards, because they are recorded.
So you can also see them later. Maybe, you might see me in one of those dance classes one of these days. Just watch out.
I hope to just send me.
Good.
So different dance classes. So
nice. I look forward to it.
Good times to go forward.
Okay. So I have a series of rapid-fire questions for you now.
Let me just tell you something.
Yes, of course.
Other online exercises, because of the sporty people, normally they say, I don't like, we try to have different classes, but they can use households and groceries to do exercise. They don't need special equipment. And then that's nice. Why not climbing stairs if possible?
Right.
A very nice play with children, dance, music. For me, dancing it's wonderful. I think we must take something that we like and start to be active even at home. But mostly to alternate between sitting time.
Yes.
When we are at home, we are always on the screening time,
sitting
normally,
yes.
And bendy positions to have some active break and do some stretching exercise. I think it is very important for the persons who are at home.
That's really, you know, because that hits home to me. I really relate with that, because I was just talking to a friend yesterday. And when we are in office, you know, we find reason to walk around, go to some colleague's desk, talk to someone, ask them a question. So you're still kind of moving around. But at home, I find that when I'm working, I'm just sitting at the desk for hours. And that's what we need to break.
Yeah.
Oh, so lots more on that coming up, and how to get people moving even when they're not interested. We're going to come to that in a few minutes. But like I said, before that, I have some rapid fire questions for you. So now how this works is that I will give you two options, and you have to just, without thinking, immediately give me your first response to it. Okay?
That's right.
So let's start. Okay. Swimming or running, which is the better calorie burner?
probably running, because it's an easy way for us.
Okay. Then
you need technique to go to that intensity that you need to burn calories running.
That's also true. And right now, these days, we don't have access to swimming pools. So probably now, running is the better way.
You can do it on the same place. It's just running. Why not?
Yeah. Okay, so running. Lifting weights or using body weight? What's better for you in the long run?
Depending on your physical fitness.
Okay.
Probably your body weight for most of the people, or not sporty people.
Okay.
It's okay.
So, okay, it's probably the better option for not very sporty people.
Yeah.
This is a nutrition-related question, but I just want your personal opinion on it. Salad for lunch or salad for dinner? What's better?
Salad for dinner.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We will sleep, so salad for dinner.
Okay. 30 minutes exercise 4 times a week or 1 hour sessions twice a week? What's better?
4 sessions?
So four times a week, 30 minutes sessions?
Yeah.
Or twice a week, 1 hour session? What's better?
I will prefer 4 times a week.
Okay.
Minutes.
Okay, I hope you guys are listening. Yoga or kickboxing, which one for beginners?
Probably yoga, but it's not easy.
That's why I ask, yeah. People think it's really easy and you just have to sit there and it's not like
not
that.
The easiest persons think about it, but probably yoga, yeah.
Okay, football or cycling, what is more popular on your campus?
Football.
I thought I knew the answer to that, but I'll ask anyway. Okay.
In Portuguese culture, soccer is football is very important.
It's like a religion, right?
Yes.
So talking about football, Cristiano Ronaldo or Luis Figo?
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Okay. And finally, for your students, team sport or individual workout, what motivates people more?
I think team sports are better.
Yes.
But sports, depending on the interests and the personality of each other, but team sports could be better for socialization and for teamwork and for discipline. I will prefer team sports.
Okay, yeah, that's actually a nice thought. It's not just about the team spirit, but like you said, also discipline, maybe. Yeah, that's nice to think about. So going ahead, Joana, the benefits of physical activity is something that, you know, organizations like the WHO and all health related organizations are always talking about. But my question to you is, how seriously do the young people or, you know, university students actually think about these issues? Think about issues like diabetes being a major killer, you know, killing millions of people around the world every year. Things like cardiovascular diseases, and that these are real threats. Do young people realize that threat?
Yeah, I think so. I think they are aware of the physical activity benefits and how physical activity can help the students, for instance, in weight management. That's their problems, and to reduce this risk of serious health issues that you mentioned. They know that physical activity reduces anxiety and stress and can help them in the routines of the daily. But what I don't know if they really realize is how much physical activity do you need to have this kind of benefits?
So tell us, how much do like young adults need to have these benefits?
What the recommendation says, the World Health Organization says, is 150 minutes of moderate intensity.
Okay.
Most of the days, so let's say 30 minutes per day of moderate intensity.
30 minutes for 5 days a week, basically.
Or 75 of vigorous activities. But let me tell you one thing that I think they don't realize as much, is that the time they are on sedentary behavior.
Yeah.
Sitting, They are always sitting, listening to classes. They are always sitting, working or studying. They are always sitting in TV viewing. And I don't know if they realize how bad this is for their health.
Yeah. So among your student community, do you find that a majority of students are naturally active and they are really participating in sport or physical activity? Or do you find that a lot of them are just not?
No. You know, we have a lot of sporty students that participate a lot in different activities. We have, but we have much students that doesn't do nothing during the day. Just to tell you what the numbers of the studies.
Yes.
Around 50 to 70% of the students demonstrate that sedentary behavior, and around 50 to 60% are inactive. This is to say that they don't get the recommendations of this 150 minutes. They don't do at least 3 days of the 7 days of workout.
Yep. So, and that is the danger going forward, isn't it? Just these sedentary lifestyles, which seem to have become the normal. And that's one of the issues that the FISU Healthy Campus project is actually trying to target, you know, being this federation, which is like a bridge between education and sport. We are hoping to impact some more holistic development and all round well-being of our students. So you're very closely involved with that project. And I'm going to ask you about that in a minute. But I also understand that physical activity does not always have to mean exercise. So can you explain that a little bit more? Because maybe people out there will be like, okay, I can do this.
Yeah, no, I will try to explain three concepts. Because as I said, sedentary behavior is also very important to realize. In fact, physical activity is the movement we do in every day. So it's the movement that is carried out by us that implies movement of the skeletal muscles, that implies energy requirements.
So it means like cooking and cleaning and just doing even household work is physical activity.
I talk a lot with my hands. Now I'm doing some. Okay. But the exercise is a subcategory of physical activity. It should be planned, structured, repetitive, and as an intention, a goal that normally it's to maintain our physical fitness. And we must realize also the sedentary behavior. I think a good way for you, Tina, to think is how do you spend your 24 hours? How many hours you spend sleeping? How many hours do you spend sitting, how many hours you spending in some activities, and in that activities, what kind of activities you do, and what is the goal of that activity, the intention of that activities, and then you can add the three concepts.
I think that's really helpful, and this is something people can apply to really just kind of take note of what they're doing in their day. And how much of it they're really not moving, how much of it they're moving but without intention, and how much of it is focused, intentional exercise. So that's cool. I'm going to think about that for myself as well going forward. Now, just lastly, Joana, about the Healthy Campus project, and it really touches upon all these issues that we just discussed. What really is the objective of a project like this that FISU is launching for someone like you? What do you hope to see achieved from it?
What I really hope to get it, it's to have this recognized international organization like FISU that can help me in the University of Porto to have a vision and a strategy to go further to a healthy campus. I think I can exchange with others what are the best practices, what are the information and guidelines in order to have higher education institutions to have skills to promote healthy environments and healthy behaviors. I think for me it will be the most important thing.
Okay.
And go and I think we also should think about health equality, trying to eliminate disparities between students, even in gender, you know, sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. So,
socioeconomics, so I think it will be also interesting how to healthy concept can be for everyone.
For everyone. So removing disparity between elite athletes and regular students, removing the gender disparities. And for you, as you said, the real objective is that universities around the world that come onto this platform will actually be able to share best practices and learn from each other and see what's working and share that knowledge.
And yeah. Try to give my experience in the University of Porto and what I learned about the literature. So I think it's a fantastic project. Well-being should be a priority in this institution's mission and vision. And so I think it's imperative to move forward with this important feature.
Yeah, that's great. And we are. And, you know, for those watching, Joana is, in fact, one of the experts that's working very closely with FISU to create this Healthy Campus Label project. It's going to be launched in just a month from now. In fact, 12th of May is the launch date for this project. And it's really far reaching in its scope. It hopes to impact millions of university students worldwide. And we're really looking forward to it. And thank you, Joana, for your participation.
To be a part of this family. So thank you for the invitation to be a part of this fantastic FISU project.
Thanks very much. And I really, really appreciate you taking out time to talk with us today.
So stay safe and active at home, please.
Yes, absolutely. And you too. Thanks a lot.
Bye.
Bye-bye.